Erythema nodosum is a skin condition that affects the subcutaneous fat layer beneath the skin. It is characterized by red, tender, and painful lumps or nodules on the skin surface, which can be anywhere from 1 to 5 centimeters in diameter. These nodules can be seen on the shins, thighs, arms, and other parts of the body. Erythema nodosum can affect anyone, but it is more commonly seen in women between the ages of 20 and 40. In this video, we will explore erythema nodosum overview, causes, symptoms, treatment, prevention, home remedies, and frequently asked questions. By the way, welcome to our channel. Don't forget to thumb up and subscribe. What is the meaning of erythema nodosum, word by word? Erythema is a medical term that refers to redness of the skin caused by inflammation. Nodosum means nodular or having nodules. So, erythema nodosum is a skin condition characterized by red, tender nodules on the skin surface, caused by inflammation of the underlying tissues. Symptoms of erythema nodosum. The symptoms of erythema nodosum include tender nodules. The primary symptom of erythema nodosum is tender, red nodules on the skin surface. These nodules are typically found on the shins, but they can appear on other parts of the body as well. Fever. Fever is another common symptom of erythema nodosum. Patients may experience a low-grade fever, usually less than 101 degrees Fahrenheit. Joint pain. Some patients may experience joint pain and stiffness, which can make movement difficult. General malaise. General malaise, which includes feelings of fatigue, weakness, and loss of appetite, is also a symptom of erythema nodosum. Causes of erythema nodosum. The exact cause of erythema nodosum is not known, but there are several factors that can contribute to its development. These factors include infection. Erythema nodosum can be a reaction to an underlying infection, such as strep throat, tuberculosis, or fungal infections. Medications. Certain medications, such as antibiotics, oral contraceptives, and nonsteroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, NSAIDs, can cause erythema nodosum. Inflammatory bowel disease. Inflammatory bowel disease, such as Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis, can also cause erythema nodosum. Pregnancy. Erythema nodosum is more common in pregnant women, although the reason for this is not fully understood. Diagnosing erythema nodosum. Erythema nodosum is typically diagnosed by a dermatologist or other healthcare provider. A physical examination of the nodules is usually sufficient to diagnose the condition, but additional tests may be necessary to determine the underlying cause. Treatment for erythema nodosum. The treatment for erythema nodosum depends on the underlying cause. In some cases, the condition may resolve on its own without any treatment. However, if the underlying cause is an infection or inflammatory disease, medications may be applied to treat the underlying condition. In addition, treatment may include pain relief. Pain relief is essential for erythema nodosum since the nodules can be very painful. Pain relief medications such as acetaminophen or ibuprofen can help relieve the pain. Rest and elevation. Resting the affected area and elevating it can also help reduce pain and inflammation. Compression stockings. Compression stockings can help reduce swelling and inflammation in the affected area. Steroids. Steroids may be used in severe cases of erythema nodosum to reduce inflammation and pain. Prevention of erythema nodosum. There is no sure way to prevent erythema nodosum since its exact cause is unknown. However, some steps can be taken to reduce the risk of developing the condition, including avoiding triggers. If you have erythema nodosum, you should avoid triggers such as certain medications, infections, or inflammatory bowel disease. Maintaining good hygiene. Maintaining good hygiene can help prevent infections that can trigger erythema nodosum. Managing chronic conditions. managing chronic conditions such as inflammatory bowel disease can reduce the risk of developing erythema nodosum. Home remedies for erythema nodosum. Here are 5 home remedy options that may help alleviate symptoms of erythema nodosum. Rest and elevation. Taking rest and elevating the affected area above the heart level can help reduce inflammation and pain. Warm compress. Applying a warm compress or taking warm baths can help relieve pain and inflammation. However, avoid hot water as it can worsen the condition. Turmeric. Turmeric has anti-inflammatory properties and can help reduce swelling and pain. Mix a teaspoon of turmeric powder in warm milk or water and drink it twice a day. Ginger. Ginger also has anti-inflammatory properties and can help reduce pain and swelling. You can either consume ginger tea or apply ginger paste on the affected area. Calendula. Calendula has anti-inflammatory and antiseptic properties and can help reduce inflammation and promote healing. Apply calendula cream or ointment on the affected area twice a day. It's important to note that while these remedies may provide some relief, they should not replace medical treatment. Be sure to consult with a healthcare professional if you suspect you have erythema nodosum. Frequently asked questions about erythema nodosum. Can erythema nodosum be cured? Erythema nodosum is a condition that can be managed with appropriate treatment. However, it is not curable. How long it will take to recover from erythema nodosum? The recovery time for erythema nodosum can vary and depends on several factors, including the underlying cause, severity of symptoms, and how quickly the condition is diagnosed and treated. In general, erythema nodosum can take several weeks to several months to fully resolve. Who is at risk of developing erythema nodosum? Erythema nodosum can affect anyone, but it is more commonly seen in women between the ages of 20 and 40. Are erythema multiforme, erythema nodosum, erythema infectiosum, erythema toxicum, and erythema marginatum similar conditions? Are there any differences between them? Erythema multiforme, erythema nodosum, erythema infectiosum, erythema toxicum, and erythema marginatum are all skin conditions that involve redness of the skin due to inflammation. The reason why they all have erythema in their names is that erythema is a medical term that refers to redness of the skin caused by inflammation. While these skin conditions share the feature of redness and inflammation, they have different causes and pathophysiologies. For example, erythema nodosum is a type of panniculitis that results from a delayed hypersensitivity reaction to various triggers, such as infections, medications, and autoimmune diseases. In contrast, erythema multiforme is a hypersensitivity reaction to certain medications or infections, such as herpes simplex virus or mycoplasma. Erythema marginatum is a skin rash that is associated with rheumatic fever, while erythema infectiosum is a viral infection caused by parvovirus B19. Erythema toxicum, on the other hand, is a common rash in newborns that is benign and self-limited. Therefore, these conditions have different pathophysiologies and causes, and should be diagnosed and treated properly by a healthcare provider. Thanks for watching. Take care and stay safe.